Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to the 2024 Halloween special for you from the Hotel Orloff, ladies and gentlemen. I soy Yomo Count Verga. Count Verga. De Pinga. Sol Yoyo. Soyamo. Los gatos. Yolota. Mo. Yala. 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 Where is it? Where is it? What a water. When the darkness falls, when the shadows become deep and black, the silent pall of evil settles upon the earth. Who dares to search, who dares to see what walks in the night? If you dare, welcome to the Hotel Orloff Halloween Special 2024 edition. It's Sunday morning, perfect time for a Halloween party, ladies and gentlemen. I was working in the lab late one night when my eyes beheld an eerie sight. A monster in my slab began to arise, and suddenly, to my surprise, he did the mash. He did the monster mash. He did the graveyard smash. He got on in a flash. He did the monster mash. From my laboratory in the castle east, to the master bedroom where the vampires feast, the ghouls all came from their humble abodes to get a jolt from my electrodes. They did the mash. They did the monster mash.
I can't do it, ladies and gentlemen. Just can't do it, ladies and gentlemen. It's not impossible. Okay. This reminds me why I've always kind of... The idea of Halloween is wonderful. I've always loved the idea of Halloween. I loved Halloween decorations. But, you know, is it just me? Or when Halloween night came along and you picked out your costume, right? And you're so excited you're going to put your costume on and go around and get candy. Halloween night, you put on that mask and you're just miserable. You can't breathe. You know, and you're going from house to house, you can't breathe, you can't see. It's really horrible. You know, am I the only one thought that? I hated it. And then you have to go to strangers' houses, knock, you know, so how cute your costume is. Oh, yeah, just give me the candy. I hated that aspect. I love Halloween decor, because to me, Halloween is all year long. So anyway, that Frankenstein mask, I thought, well, I'll wear that on Captain Strangelife's Halloween special on October 22nd, Sunday night, because it's like he wants everyone to be in costume. And I thought, well, I'll just wear my Frankenstein mask. I can't take that, man. After what they put us through with that pandemic where we had to wear those stupid masks just to get into a supermarket. That was horrible, ladies and gentlemen. Horrible. Horrific. You couldn't breathe, and I couldn't breathe in that mask. I can't take it. I can't sing the monster mash with that horrible mask on. So I'm going to have to come up with some other way to come on Captain Strangelife's show. Look, it's the head of a hippie. How about that? Severed head of a hippie, ladies and gentlemen. Well... Tell you what, we're going to do this Halloween special without a mask on, And I'm going to let you watch Drew here, and I'll be right back. Well, it's almost 8:30 in the morning here on a beautiful, rainy Sunday morning here in Rural Retreat, Virginia. Yeah, normal people, NPCs, Halloween is the when they put up the spooky decorations, and it's when they show the comic book people. It's like, I'm going to show the spooky books now because it's Halloween. I know it's a cliche, all the goth people say, it's Halloween all year long for me. Well, it is for me. It's been that way forever. Except Halloween, yeah, I love Halloween decorations, but the actual ritual of Halloween, going door to door, not being able to breathe, that was always miserable for me. And if you really think about it, you feel the same way too. I don't know. Where do I put this mask where it won't be destroyed by the dog? Jehoshaphat, jumping, Jehoshaphat. See, my wife is a licensed cosmetologist, and they have these tripod things, and then they put heads on them. And this is how they practice learning to cut hair on these plastic heads with hair on them. I don't know if you know about that. So this hippie's head goes on this tripod, right? This is my wife's stuff. And then I was putting this Frankenstein head on top of the hippie. Whoa. So I'll put it back. Yeah, that reminds me why I'm gonna have to actually do something different with makeup where I can breathe, because going through all of that ridiculous COVID stuff, you know, putting on a mask, yeah. I don't know about that. Hold on a second, ladies and gentlemen. Ah, shit. Dang it, I don't know how to do this. Anyway. Oh, wow. Come on, man. Come on, man. I'll fix this later. Oh, shit. Okay, there we go. Well, ladies and gentlemen, sorry. You came here for entertainment. To No more masks for me. When they tried to start a new pandemic there about a month ago and said, we're all going to mask back up. And everyone said, no, thank you. We fool me once, fool me twice. Yeah, that kind of garbage, whatever that cliche is. I read it in a fortune cookie. All right, so we'll be talking about Halloween and looking at some Halloween decorations and having fun here this beautiful Sunday morning. And it's the 15th. It's not even close to Halloween, but I'm glad I did this so I know not to wear that mask because I could not sit there for 2-3 hours, however long Captain Strangelife's Amazing Special will last. So, having said that, So, let's get this music a little louder, ladies and gentlemen. We're gonna have a party. I was looking in the lab late one night when my eyes beheld an eerie sight. For my monster from his slab began to rise, and suddenly, to my surprise, he did the mash. He did the monster mash. It was a graveyard smash. Caught on in a flash, he did the monster mash. From my laboratory in the castle east to the master bedroom where the vampires feast, the ghouls all came from their humble abode to get a jolt from my electrodes. They did the mash. They did the monster mash. It was a graveyard smash. They did the mash. Caught on in a flash. They did it was the monster mash. Zombies were having fun. The party had just begun. Their guests included Wolfman, Dracula, and his son. The scene was rocking, all were digging the sounds. Igor on chains, backed by his baying hounds. The coffin bangers were about to arrive with their vocal group, the Crypt Kicker Five. They played the monster mash. It was a graveyard smash. It caught on in a flash. They played the monster mash. From the coffin, Drag's voice did ring. Seems he was troubled by just one thing. He opened the lid and shook his fist and said, whatever happened to my Transylvania twist? Now the mash. It's now the monster mash. And it's a graveyard smash. It caught on in a flash. It's now the monster mash. Now everything's cool, Drek's a part of the band, and my monster mash is the hit of the land. To you, the living, this mash was meant to. When you get to them doors, maybe Boris sent you. Then you can mash. You get monster mash. And do my graveyard smash. You'll catch on in a flash. Then you get monster mash. Mash good, easy you go, you impetuous young boy. Mash good, shut up. Oh, I'll have to kill you now, Igor. Yes, indeed. Yes, indeed, yes, indeed. Well, how about that, ladies and gentlemen? Bobby Boris Pickett from 1961, right? It was about 61, or was it 60? I think it was 61. Yes, indeed, ladies and gentlemen. How about that? Terrible karaoke version that they have here on YouTube. They didn't have all the backing vocals. There should have been like a girl chorus in the background saying they did the mash, but they had relied on me to say that part. These scum, they don't know how to do karaoke. Okay, well, that's the real theme to Halloween. If you play Michael Jackson's Thriller at your Halloween party, you're part of the problem. You're worse than Joe Biden and the World Economic Forum. Get rid of that song. That song should not be the anthem of Halloween. That song is vastly inferior to the Monster Mash. You know that. Michael Jackson didn't do, he was great as in the Jackson 5, but you know, I'm sick and tired of all this Michael Jackson worship. Luckily, most people have forgotten about Michael Jackson. He was good as a little kid. Then he became this bizarre, horrible thing. Speaking of horrible things, ladies and gentlemen. Speaking of horrible things, ladies and gentlemen. Ghouls rush in where angels fear to tread. And so I come to you, my love, my heart above my head. Though I see the danger there, if there's a chance for me, then I don't care. Ghouls rush in where wise men never go, but wise men never fall in love, so how are they to know? When we met, I felt my life begin. So open up your heart and let this fool rush in. Ghoul rush in. Sorry, ladies and gentlemen. Yesterday, ladies and gentlemen, Ricky Nelson. One of my, you know, I bought a Ricky Nelson's Greatest Hits record and his plane crashed that night, New Year's Eve, 1985? Or 86, felt really guilty. I thought, because I bought that record, maybe it caused, you know, oh well. But I wasn't responsible for Lynyrd Skynyrd, I'll have you know that. I had nothing to do with that. I was too young to buy Lynyrd Skynyrd records. Ghouls rush in where wise men never go, but wise men never fall in love, so how are they to know? When we met, I met my Shabagabadoola. So open up your heart and let this fool rush in. So open up your heart and let this ghoul rush in.
I'm so embarrassed.
Open up your heart and let this ghoul rush in. We're never going to wear any masks again, are we, Drew?
You said it.
Yes, indeed. What horrible song will the Martian subject me to next here on this nightmare of karaoke? Karaoke, yes, indeed. What will it be? I have no idea what's coming next. Oh, I'm doing better today, pain-wise. Oh, you know something, ladies and gentlemen? Everyone's saying so yeah lately, and it's just driving me crazy. Wise men say, only fools say so yeah. But I can't help saying so yeah to you. Shall I say so, yeah? Would it be a sin if I can't help saying so, yeah, to like a comic collector goes showing their comic books. Darling, so it goes. Some people just have to say so, yeah. Take my hand. Take my whole life. For I can't help. say.
So yeah.
To you. People just keep saying so yeah. It used to be or like a river flows surely to the sea. Darling, so it goes. Some things were meant to be. You can't fight it. It's just become part of the lexicon, ladies and gentlemen. Take my life. Cut off my head and my limbs too. For I just can't help it, ladies and gentlemen. Saying so, yeah, to you. If you would just stop saying so, yeah, it wouldn't get in my head, and it makes me sad, for I can't help saying so, yeah, to you, ladies and gentlemen. It's a hit song from Elvis Presley. Well, how's that? What song will be coming up next? I better get my guitar just in case. What will it be? Oh my gosh. Will it be Country Roads by John Denver? Will it be, what will it be? I don't know. Okay. Let me get my wife's guitar, man. Who knows what's gonna come up next? Oh shit. Oh man. Yeah, get my guitar in tune here. Oh yes, let's jump it. Slow ride. Take it easy. Slow ride, take it easy. All right, take it easy. Slow ride, take it easy. In the mood, I'm in the mood, oh yeah. The rhythm is right. Move to the music. We can roll all night. Yeah, whatever. Ooh. Slow ride. Take it easy. Slow ride. Take it easy. Slow death. Go down. Go to get your loving, ladies and gentlemen, here at the Cibola Inn. One more time, ladies and gentlemen. Hold me. Roll me. Slow riding, woman, you'll love. Brought you in color, the live, brought to our live Halloween special. Ladies and gentlemen, Fog at the Immortal Band. I'm in the mood. The rhythm is right. Move to the music, yeah. We can roll all night, yeah. Slow ride. Take it easy. Will this song ever end? Slow ride. Take it easy. Slow down. Go down. Go to get your room one more time. Excuse me. Oh, man. Roll me. Slow down. easy. Slow ride. Sleazy. Slow ride. Easy. Slow ride.
All right, sleazy, ladies and gentlemen, just like the Cibola Inn here in Arlington, Texas. And have you had a wonderful day, ladies and gentlemen? How are you doing today, this Sunday morning? Well, let's go around and look at Halloween stuff around the Hotel Orloff, ladies and gentlemen. Because that's what you're here for, to celebrate Halloween. Okay, so we have some vintage Halloween candy collectors. Yes, indeed. What else is Halloween in here? Let's look and see what kind of decorations. And this is stuff that's up all year. You know, this is not. Let's see. Is this Halloween oriented over here? Let's see. What Halloween? What kind of Halloween spooky stuff is over here? Well, let's see. There is the lawgiver from Planet of the Apes. Oh, that Madball is spooky. What else? There's some skulls. There's the Green Goblin. And she's some action figure from, I don't know what she is. Some kind of He-Man knockoff, but I always thought she was cool. There's King Kong, ladies and gentlemen. Yes, indeed. There's the Count. All right. And Ed Gein back here, he's awfully spooky. Yes, indeed. There's Steve McQueen. Okay, it's Revolt of the Zombies. What other stuff will evoke a feeling of terror in you, the viewer? Let's turn on the light. Horror. Oh. Yes, indeed. Horror, indeed. Oh, we gotta get some music playing. Oh, I'll just put on a disc. Oh, so, it's almost Christmas time. Isn't that amazing? Okay. What else we got here? Black cat, ladies and gentlemen.
Are you sure you don't need any assistance?
Thank you. Anyway, I've already contacted my people, and they will be here shortly.
Very well, then we shall be going. Goodbye.
Well, yes, it's 8:45 in the morning here at the Hotel Orloff.
Our forces will join you shortly.
Well, let's go look at some Halloween masks down in the basement. Spooky. What do you want to see, man? You know what kind of ruined Halloween? Another thing that ruined Halloween is the Elvira. The thing that ruined Halloween, well, it's Spirit Halloween stores. They're pretty horrible. My idea of Halloween is more of an innocent thing. And when Spirit stores opened, it's like they would always open, you know, they took advantage of the economy. When some big giant store went out of business, they would descend on this big empty cavernous space and they'd open up a Spirit Halloween store. But all the Halloween decorations that they have are not the Halloween decorations I remember as a kid. The Halloween decorations I remember as a kid were far more innocent and fun. and mid-century looking, as opposed to Spirit has just like prosthetic latex heads with, you know, hooks through their eyes and stuff. To me, Halloween is more like the Groovy Ghoulies or Bela Lugosi or Dracula. Oh, he's glow in the dark too. Let's see if we can make him glow in the dark, ladies and gentlemen. We'll put him up to the light. We'll lift him up, much like Frankenstein was lifted to the lightning. Okay. Oh, let's do it with this Forgotten Prisoner of Castlemere model kit, too. This isn't my childhood model kit. This is one I bought at an estate sale. And luckily, they didn't paint over the glow-in-the-dark parts. Okay, let's see if they glow. Yeah, his hands are glowing a bit. See that? His eyes glow, too. I probably didn't put it up long enough. I need to be doing this show like at midnight. That would be better, ladies and gentlemen. Anyway, that's Dracula, ladies and gentlemen. Let's put him there next to James T. Kirk and his pal the Mummy and the Hulk and all my childhood friends. There's the Addams Family house. If you look really carefully in this Aurora model kit, you can see Gomez and Morticia. And Lurch, I can't really tell what I'm pointing at, so hopefully you're seeing these things. There's an Addams Family Viewmaster reel back there. What else is Halloween-y? The Mummy. The Creature from the Black Lagoon. Frankenstein's Monster. Batman. Hey, this is probably the scariest one.
I think you're nice.
The Wolfman. The Forgotten Prisoner of Castlemere. The Blot. Yeah. Okay, so this is what this is how Halloween decorations should be. That's what Spirit should be selling. Stuff like this. A rock Halloween a go-go. A skeleton with a guitar and a witch doing a go-go witch. That's what Halloween should be, ladies and gentlemen. But I'm not in charge of popular culture. I try to do my part with this rinky-dink YouTube show that is watched by about a couple hundred people. But maybe I'm making some contribution to culture. I don't know. This is kind of frightening. Howdy doody there. Looks like he's been in the ring for a few rounds with David Nino Rodriguez. We're here in the monster corner, ladies and gentlemen. That was painted by Joe Riley. Look at Joey Ramone there. Wendy, the good little witch. That's the kind of Halloween I like. I like the more innocent Halloween. But that's just me. You might like all the gory stuff. I mean, it's not that I don't like gory movies, you know. Halloween to me is a children's holiday. Much like I wanna make this snake glow. See, I didn't paint this. I forgot who did. I think I bought it on eBay. See the James Bama painting on the cover, on the front of the box for the Mummy or a kit. Is he's kind of painted with a blue light reflecting on him. So really clever model kit builders paint him with the blue glow on him. See, it looks really cool. Yeah, someone with some great skill did that. But this person left the snake, the cobra, in the glow form. So, what's cool on these model kits, if you look at the bottom, it says, do you see that? It says Aurora. Aurora Plastics Corporation, 1963. Yeah. So, the mummy model kit came out just a few months before the assassination of John F. Kennedy. Just to give you historical perspective. Okay, I'm trying to make this snake glow. Okay, turn off the lights. See him glowing? Look at that. That's pretty darn cool. PDC, pretty darn cool. Start my new my own acronym. That's neat. Yeah. Yes, indeed. Oh, my gosh. Well, almost all the pain I was complaining about yesterday has dissipated. I don't yet have any pain in my back. I still have some right in my right knee. That's where, but I'm just going to keep, you know, eating better and losing weight. And I've given up soft drinks a couple of, that was kind of hard to do. I gave up soft drinks a couple of months ago. I highly advise that you do that because the stuff that's in those soft drinks is not the same stuff that was in them when you were a kid. It's horrible, ladies and gentlemen. Anyway, I'll show you. I've got some Halloween masks on a wall down here. Let's go look at them. Oh, we're entering the spook house. Here's Carolyn Jones's autograph. Look at that. See that? And there's another autograph of Carolyn Jones and John Astin. What else is Halloween? Oh, look, Gunnar Hansen, the real Leatherface, has autographed this to me, to Kenneth, which is my real birth name. Ouch. Okay, we're going down to the spooky basement. Oh boy. Well, I did two shows yesterday, one canned show and one live show. You need to tune them in. I can only do shows on weekends, really. Just the way it is. Okay. So what will you be this Halloween? Will you be a Viking? Will you be a witch? A Biden voter? That looks like someone that would vote for Joe Biden. Will you be the Wolfman? The Mummy? Will you be a vampire girl? Will you be Richard Nixon? Now, Richard Nixon was a great president. Don't listen to the media. Will you be Golden Bat, a Japanese superhero that not many people in the United States have heard of? Will you be this melting man kind of guy? Will you be this hungover drunk person? Will you? Or will you be this another Democrat Biden voter? She's very progressive. Will you be this caveman? Or will you be this vampire girl with red freckles? What will you be, ladies and gentlemen? There's Elvira and Vampirella. And look, it's the Fantastic Four, but two of them have fallen right over. I don't endorse Funko Pops, but sometimes... what? Sometimes you just gotta, you know, I've made mistakes, but...
When I see these Jack Kirby looking ones, I gotta get them. Okay, stop falling over, Sue Storm. Oh. Dang it. What is wrong with these? That's because these normal people buy these Funko Pops, right? And they keep them in the boxes. Then they don't have to worry about them falling over. These actually were pretty stable back in the old country. I don't know why they're falling over here. All right. I have a Thing one. Where's the Thing one? Is in the other room. Oh, I should put this Frankenstein up on the porch for on display. You could also be a gorilla on the back of this box of Kellogg's Corn Flakes. Or you could look at this Lily Munster. This thing was at Dollar General. They had this for several years at Dollar General. It's a bootleg Lily Munster. Look at that. They might still be selling it. Oh, you could also be this Bride of Frankenstein. Okay, the Thing must be in the other room. Yes, indeed. Oh yeah. I've got several of these things down here. Is that the same as the creature from the Black Lagoon you have at Gotham City Comics, Kevin? This one I got, I'd say at least three or four years ago. But it's Amigo, I think. I don't know who put it out. But you were showing one, and I'm not sure if it's the exact same design. Anyway, how about that? More Halloween decorations. Halloween decorations are everywhere here. It's just... That's my world, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to my world. Won't you step on in? Miracles, they say, still happen now and then. Yes, indeed. Let's see what I weigh. I'm going to weigh myself. Of course, this camera will add a little bit to it. I was weighed the other day at the doctor. They said I was 240, man. This says, oh, man, 245. Can't be. It has to be the phone in my hand. I'm sure that adds 5 pounds. I got to lose weight, man. I really should be about 160. I'm 6 foot, although they measured me the other day and they said I was 5'10". That means my spine is shrinking. Either that or I was slouching. I've always been 6 foot, like, my whole adult life. So, something's horrible. I think there's more gravity here in Roll Retreat, Virginia, than there is back in Texas. More north you go. Oh, David Wilcox is going to be on today. Wow, that's great news. David Wilcox is this wonderful guy I like to listen. He's doing a live stream on YouTube. David Wilcox. He's you always see him on those Ancient Aliens kind of shows. He's a very entertaining guy. Right, Drew the dog? Oh, look, it's Mr. and Mrs. J. Evil Scientist. Okay, let me rewind that. I did it wrong. Never mind. Yes, indeed. This is going to be a very unpopular episode. Watch, there's not going to be many viewers of this episode because people come here to see comic books, ladies and gentlemen. They don't like it when I show other stuff.
Look, it's Ed Wood. As painted by Joe Riley. And that's Clara Bow. This painting once actually was in her house. It hung in her house. That was her painting. I don't know who the painter is, but a friend of mine bought it when he lived in Hollywood. My friend Tom Rinaldi, he had such a huge collection that, you know, he'd sell me little things from his collection when he needed some extra money. Okay. Well, we're back. Yesterday I did a live stream, and afterwards I shut the computer off, and now I come back almost 24 hours later. It says working on updates, 98%, don't turn off your computer. How long should I leave that going? Does it take that long to do an update? I don't know. I'm tempted to just turn it off. I don't really like these updates. Usually what they do is they mess up your computer when the computer updates. That's what I found. What did you just do, Mr. Drew? Oh, I see. That's not your fault. Moving this chair over. Okay. Okay, let's look at some comic books. Let's see if we can find any Halloween-related books. You know, whatever. Oh, I'll put it over here. That's what I'll do. Oh. Okay. Looking at independent books here. Halloween. Oh, look at this. Adventures of Shoney's Big Boy. So he's too big there. There just happens to be a big boy right here. It's funny how these things work out. This guy's way too big. It's like an adult big boy. It's kind of embarrassing. Okay. This is a highly sought after key issue. Oh, look at this, man. How fortuitous. Look, it's a Halloween issue. Look at that. This is one of Klaus Schwab's earliest penciling jobs. Look at that. Free hot fudge cake. Junior fried shrimp. This big boy chain in Texas, it was called Kip's Big Boy. In California, it was called Bob's Big Boy. And apparently, it was called Shoney's elsewhere. This one was sent to me free by Kevin Johnson at Gotham City Comics, who is one of the most wonderful comic stores in the country. Uh-oh, I'm getting low battery. I need to go get the charger. What is he looking at there? Okay. Oh my gosh. Look, this bird drops like a bomb or something, and it blows up these people on a golf course. It's like horrifying. Big Boy's rescuing them. I'll have to read that to find out what happens next. Yeah, you'll never know what you'll find in these long boxes, ladies and gentlemen. You guys ever eat at Big Boy restaurant? Tell me down below. I loved that place. I thought their food was delicious. Look, watch TV special, The Wizard of Oz on CBS. Yeah, that's what it was called in Texas, Kip's Big Boy. This is an actual copy I have from my childhood.
Oh, I have two copies of this. Probably because I've got two copies from... When you went to the cashier, they'd have them in a stack there. And I probably picked up two copies. What is this one from? I can't read any. Okay, I'll tell you what. We're going downstairs. We're going to find our magnifying glass, and we're going to get the phone charger. All right. Here's a Twiggy. Look at that, Twiggy. Twiggy 8-track. The great thing about 8-tracks is they play constantly. That's what I've been trying to remember for two episodes. I need to pay homage to a great guy that passed away this last week. The other day I was talking about Mark Goddard passing away and Phyllis Coates and Keith Geffen. Whenever I say that, I keep thinking of Geffen Records, like Casablanca or whatever. But that's a comic artist and writer that is very revered. I don't know him because I've never read those comics from the late 80s or 90s, whenever Ambush Bug and the humorous Justice League comic. But there have been a lot of people passing away in the last week. But this friend of mine, he ran a record store. When I first met him, he ran a record store on Lower Greenville Avenue in Dallas, Texas. It was called 14 Records. There was a reason he called it 14 Records. He told me the story once. I don't remember the story, but it was called 14 Records. And it was an amazing record store. I don't think I ever bought many records from him, but I bought other things. He'd make these great cassette collages of fantastic music, weird music he had found on records, and he would make these compilations with commercials in between and things. His name was James Big Bucks Burnett. He went by Big Bucks. A lot of people just called him Bucks. I'm looking for my, there it is, my magnifying glass. I met him in the 90s. He was also a good friend of my friend Randy. And the dog and the cat are about to have a battle. But you don't want to watch that. But he passed away this week, Beck. He had that great store. What I would buy also, he got this big stash of 1960s National Enquirers once. And I bought some from him. I've shown you some of them. I think one of them might be in here. Yeah, he was a neat guy. He was really funny. He was, he ran the Tiny Tim fan club. And he was friends with Tiny Tim. He also ran the Mr. Ed fan club. And he would have rock festivals in Dallas or Denton or somewhere with, he had one called Tiny Palooza. Hold on a second, I'm plugging this in. He had a rock festival called Tiny Palooza with all these bands, and I think Tiny Tim would perform. And then he had another rock festival called Ed Stock in honor of Mr. Ed, the talking horse from television. And he was always into rock and roll music. In his record store, he had an 8-track museum. He would collect all these rare 8-tracks, and he had them all like under glass, like they were super valuable, you know, treasure, because most people consider 8-tracks just to be like worthless, obviously, but he was treating them like revered objects, and that was always fun to go in his record store and see the 8-track museum. He put out a fanzine called 8-Track Mind about 8-Tracks and how wonderful they were. He'd be invited to England, and he'd hang out at Jimmy Page's castle. I guess it used to be Aleister Crowley's castle. Jimmy Page loved him. A lot of these, you know, a lot of us, we go see The Who and Led Zeppelin, whatever. He was friends with them
because was the nicest guy in the world and was funny. It just, people liked to hang out with him. I think the second to last sale he made from his 8-track museum, because people would buy these 8-tracks, and he put high prices on them, and it was kind of part of the fun to be going in there and paying a high price for an 8-track, because it was just... I think Pete Townsend was the second to last person to buy an 8-track from him. He actually knew these people, and they loved him. Everyone loved Big Bucks. For a while, the last time I saw him... Well, sometimes I'd see him at my friend Randy's house. He'd be over there with his wife, and sometimes I would... Then later on, he didn't have his record store anymore. I'd see him working at other record stores in the area. He worked at, I think, Collector's Records, and he worked at Forever Young in Arlington, which was a giant record store. It must be one of the biggest, as far as square footage and amount of records. It must be one of the biggest record stores in the world. Very pricey. Every record in there started at $25. And this was back before, $15 to $25. And that's before the vinyl resurgence started, you know, where everyone started going crazy about records. But he's a great guy. And he passed away. I think he was maybe 64. He's a few years older than me. Okay, now I can read the date. This is from 1980. And this one... So how's your wonderful Halloween going? Oh, look at this. This one's, somebody's trying to make it all Beatle-y here. Looks like the Blue Meanies from Yellow Submarine. Yeah, these comics were always insane looking. I think they were doing them all through the 60s. The older ones, I don't know how many survive, but, the older ones might have better art, but I don't have any super old ones. This is, oh, I see, it's from 1977. 1977 scrapbook. Yeah, that's when my family would eat at Kip's Big Boy, and then... Yeah, how about that? Yeah, they would put a price tag on it to make you think you were getting something. Look, it says 25 cents free to our guest, but obviously no one ever paid 25 cents for this. I wonder what these sell for now, you know, on mycomicshop.com. Is there a collector market? I mean, this is issue 235, which means that this probably goes back... Oh, yeah, it probably goes back to probably early 60s. This has letters from kids that wrote in to Big Boy. That would be a good costume to have, is to be Kip's Big Boy. All you'd have to do is be fat and get this little checkered outfit and just make your hair all swoopy. Oh, this is... Look, it's the 1976 reader survey, so this one's actually earlier. This is 235... Here's 238. Anyway, Big Bucks Burnett. I just I just have to give him a salute, and he made a lot of people happy in his life. He's got like a Flash Gordon kind of guy. So there's all these people paying tribute to him on Facebook, and just people that have never met him but talked to him by phone for hours. People love the guy. Everyone loves Big Bucks Burnett. Here's one I got from Big Bucks. This National Enquirer from September 27th, 1964. How many copies still exist of a 1964 National Enquirer? It says the world's liveliest paper. National Enquirer was more of a freak show back then. It would When I was a kid in the 1970s, my mom would buy the National Enquirer. It was more of a gossip sheet. But in the 60s, it had a lot more blood in it. And it was just sleazier, more bloody stuff, and people that were born freaks. I'm giving away 9 of my 13 children. I'm killing myself trying to make the world happy, says Jerry Lewis. Look at him there, drinking. How do I make him happier? I know how you feel, Jerry. I'm trying to make the world happier with this show. I mean, I really am. Woman surgeon hacked to pieces by mystery killer. Man eats dogs, hammers the pooches to death, skins and chops them up, boils them, and flavors the stew with herbs and spices. See, this is the kind of stuff we were dealing with. Power mower shoots a piece of wire into man's heart. And two-headed girls and stuff. So that's how National Enquirer used to be. And so as a kid, I would get the Mad specials that would reprint the old Mad stuff that was really even better than the stuff I was reading in the 70s. So I saw this 1960s Mad parody of National Enquirer with art by Al Jaffe, who could really draw grotesque stuff. And I think it had like a dog puking out on the cover or something, just horrible stuff. And I was aware that National Enquirer used to be have a different tone to it than the one that my mom was buying she'd buy the Globe and the Enquirer and the Tattler when we go to the supermarket. Here's Mamie Van Doren. He had tons of these. I got the ones that I wanted. I wish I could have gotten them all, but he put high prices on them, which might be, it might be right, because this is back in the 90s I got these. It might be right because where do you see these? 33-year-old Mamie Van Doren says, I married a teenager, but he's all man. Of course, Mamie Van Doren's now probably 90, pushing 90. I mean, she was, you know, like a contemporary of Marilyn Monroe. She was, there was Marilyn Monroe, there was Jane Mansfield, then there was Mamie Van Doren. Now, Mamie Van Doren was beautiful, but how do I be polite about this? She was, oh my gosh. She had a lot of boyfriends. Is that a nice way of saying it? This is horrible pictures of a baby that was born with 4 arms and 4 legs. But now she's normal. It shows pictures of the surgery that I just don't want to show you. It's horrible. And then there's a picture of a baby that scalded, 22-year-old dad scalds baby to death with, oh my God. There's a picture of someone that supposedly just committed suicide. The gun, it's like a Luger on their chest and there's blood coming. It's, yeah, I don't want to show this stuff. Mamie Van Doren says she married baseball pitcher Lee Myers because he's young, athletic, and loads of fun, and because he will soon inherit millions. Anyway, there's some horrifying stuff in this particular issue. This is 1966. I guess it got worse. This is also 66. Raquel Welch says, I'm not the greatest actress, but but I look good as a cavewoman. And the back cover shows someone holding a severed head. And I'm not going to show you that either, because I don't want to get in trouble with the YouTube cops. But enough of that in our community. Man, I can't stand that word community. No one uses that word community except for communists. So we got to stop using it in socialists. We got to stop using it here in the comic book community. Let's start calling ourselves the comic book neighborhood. You're not gonna do it, because I'm not an influencer. No one cares. But I can't stand it, man. I can't stand the word community. What are we gonna do next? Call ourselves comrade? You know, I click and bring on. Hello, comrade. Comrade graphic man. No, we're not gonna do that here. Learn the secrets of the stars, says Madame Zeus. Oh, I don't know who Janine Vila is, but who was Janine Vila? She's someone that no one remembers today. This is in a little gossip column. Oh, I don't know, man. I don't know. Oh my gosh. What is wrong with these people? Mom sets herself on fire in prison, dies 5 days later. Oh, that's nice. This is some kid that looks like he's a thalidomide baby. He has no arms or no hands and legs. And this is the big double. The centerfold in this thing, man. It's like a couple have two panthers, a tiger, and two ocelots, and now they're looking for a leopard and a lion. Okay. Here's American Motors 1967 line. The Rambler Rebel, the Marlin, the Rambler Rogue, and the Ambassador. Dad plugs in tea kettle in kitchen and accidentally electrocutes daughter in bathtub. Where's the Raquel Welch article? Oh, look at this. Teenager is nabbed for converting fountain pens into guns. He probably works for Blank Branch. For, you know, James Bond. I don't think you're allowed to say that letter. It's LMNOP blank RSD. You're not supposed to say that letter on YouTube because the AI will think you're talking about some conspiracy theories regarding Trump. I don't think that letter's allowed to be said, but you know, the Blank Branch and the James Bond books and movies, that guy, you know, or maybe he works for Uncle. Where's the Raquel Welch article, ladies and gentlemen? Oh, Joy Lansing. It's Joy Lansing. I know who Joy Lansing is.